just, I want to be very clear about something. So basically, to use the Bills and Chiefs game as an example,
yes.
Chiefs get the ball, they score. Under the new format, the Bills would get the chance to score. If they scored also, it would then be the next score wins?
Sudden death. Yes.
Sudden death at that point in time.
And so, you know, because we, one thing that, that Troy and his office have done a great job of is there's just a lot more analytics we have available to us today. And so we did a lot of study in that. I think the belief is from those people and talking to teams is in that instance, there's a good chance the second team goes for two. There's a good chance that you say, you know what, this game's been going on, I may go for two here, which is fine. That's fine. But that, you know, it could be that, yes, it just happens and they kick off and it truly is pure sudden death. Field goal wins.
Brian, if you don't mind, I want to ask something to Albert's point. One of the things also that was factored in was the fans' point. You know, part of the data that we pulled was the fandom during that time of OT. I'm a traditionalist. Get off the field defensively, either get your offense back the ball or you stop them. But when you factor in good football, both people want to touch. You know, the fan wants to see his quarterback touch the ball. The data drove us to that. So all of those things were factored in. We don't talk about that much, but that's part of, you know, the fans make the game go. And when they were tuned in, the data showed those two overtime games, viewership went through the roof. And all of those things were factored in, and it was hard with the 10-2 factors over the last, you know, 12 years. You factor in people tuning in. You factor in two of the best quarterbacks that the game has to offer. All of those things were important, and I believe, in moving the floor in the direction that they went.
Yeah, thanks. Rich, Sal from WGR in Buffalo. As you can see in Buffalo, we're invested in this overtime thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I just want to clarify to make sure. There is no second coin toss if it's still tied, right? It just goes right to the next team?
Yes.
And is there still a time component where time would run out and a new quarter begins, and how would that take shape?
Yeah, so yes, time will not run out with the game running out. You're guaranteed a possession. So you have the entire possession. Just give an example. Team A gets the ball, scores in 11 minutes, and there's 4 minutes to go. You don't have to score in 4 minutes. You get that ball until your possession is over. As soon as you turn the ball over, for whatever reason, then you're done. But you will, we'll flip the field after 15 minutes. That's what the current rule provides. But it is your ball, and you're not limited by the time. Totally different in the regular season, and I think we've come to accept that. We like the 10-minute limit in the regular season. You know, player health and safety, and we like that. In this one, there is no limit. There's a quarter, but you're going to flip it, and you're still entitled to your possession.
Last question, Troy.
Troy, you talk about the taunting rule and how